Slope fields are an interesting qualitative method for studying an ordinary differential equation of the form dy dx equals f of xy. Now, by qualitative, I mean that it's not quantitative. We don't actually get any explicit solutions or anything like that. We only get an idea as to how the solutions look. So I describe it as being a way of making a picture of the solutions to dy dx equals f of xy without actually knowing the solutions explicitly. So let me just give you an idea as to how it works. So the idea is that by definition, the slope of a solution to this differential equation at a point xy is f of xy. That's because dy dx equals f of xy. So what we do is we draw in on the plane, the xy plane, we draw in tiny slopes all over the plane. And these are like little tiny tangent lines to the solutions. And we try to make the solutions fit with all those tiny tangent lines. Now this is vague, so let me do an example to show you how it works. So we start off with dy dx equals y minus x. That'll be our example. Now I have drawn the plane here, and this grid is length 1, so each of these little unit lengths is length 1. So this is the point 1, 0, this is the point 1, 1, etc. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go around to each one of these grid points, just by example. I could really go anywhere I want, but I'll go around to each one of these grid points, and I'll draw in a little tiny tangent line with slope y minus x at the point x comma y. So here I've done it. So let me just choose a couple of these guys. So for example, the point 0, 0, 0, 0, I draw on a little tiny line which has slope y minus x, x which is 0 minus 0. Over here at the point 1, 0, I draw on a little tiny line which has slope 0 minus 1, which is minus 1. Up here at, say, the point 0, 1, I draw on a little tiny line which has a slope of 1, which is the same as 1 minus 0. And I do that all over the plane. Now another way to do this is to fix a value of y minus x. So for instance, I could fix y minus x equals 0. That's the line y equals x. And everywhere along that line in this plane, I need to draw a little tiny line of slope 0, because y minus x is 0 on that line. So you can see this is the line right here, y equals x. And I've drawn at those grid points little lines of slope 0. I could choose, say, y minus x equals 1. Along the line y minus x equals 1, I would need to draw little lines of slope 1. And I've done that here. Here's y minus x equals 1, and there's little lines of slope 1, etc. Now, the idea of making the solutions fit them is to kind of draw the solution curves in so that these little lines are tangent lines to the solution curve everywhere the solution curve hits them. So I've done that very roughly. I'm not very good at drawing these pictures, but you get the idea. You can kind of see how the solution curves will flow, how they'll move with these tangent lines. Now, we can use this to gain qualitative information, not exact information, but we can make some deductions. So for instance, I could ask you the question, if y of 4 is 0, what is y of minus 4? So in other words, if I have a solution which passes through the point 4 comma 0, then what is the value of that solution at x equals minus 4? And we can actually conclude, make a pretty good conclusion as to what it would be. So let's go over here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here I am over here. What would that solution curve do? Well, that solution curve would kind of flow up this way. Again, this picture is going to be kind of bad, but it would flow up this way and then go with this flow back down to sort of hug this line here. And so you'd imagine that as it travels down this way, once I get to minus 4, I go over 1, 2, 3, 4, here I am over here, and I'll be kind of hugging this line y equals x plus 1, so I would be down here at minus 3. And you'll find, if you do a numerical experiment or if you solve this equation exactly, that we're pretty darn close to being accurate, that this would actually be minus 3, very close to it.